Gonzalez. I'm a pianist and entertainer and a proud collaborator on Random Access Memories by Daft Punk. Oh, I met them here and there at different soirees. They came to a couple of concerts of mine around the early 2000s, and they asked me to contribute a remix for Discovery of the song Too Long. My personal favorite mode of Daft Punk is the ballads with the crying robot. So I thought, well, I'm just gonna purposefully mishear the word remix spoken with a French accent and hear the word remake instead. You know, remix, remake, they sound pretty similar.
It's been much too long. I feel it coming on. The feeling's getting strong.
I turned it into this 70s ballad because that's what I always heard in those Daft Punk ballads. The modern tools, you know, the vocoders and the auto-tune and whatever else they were using. Of course, they get a lot of credit for that because those are the modern elements that have since dominated pop music. But less so sometimes do people realize how timeless the songwriting really is. When a song is divorced of its production, and you play something on a piano, there you see if it passes the test of just being musically sound. And Daft Punk songs do work on the piano. So you realize that when songwriting is that good, it doesn't matter how it's dressed, it's always going to create that emotional response. So even if they had been songwriters back in the 70s, they would have been creating timeless masterpieces. And so now, looking back on Within, and if I just play the melody itself, I mean, that is just such classic writing and storytelling. You could basically play it on any instrument in any era. It just so happens the one that they chose has a crying robot and a Rhodes piano and some other elements.
C'était avant en fait que tu fasses vraiment la, tu vois, après tu es rentré dans le truc, mais les accords que tu as fait juste avant.
Yeah, I incorporated one of the themes from your songs, didn't I?
Yeah.
I was trying to, but it just kind of came
is,
in, but
as well, just before you incorporated, okay. Uh-huh. I mean, you incorporated it in a more straightforward way at some point, which was really, I mean, which was...
You know, the robots had a vision for how to use me. So we kind of laser focused in on what was going to happen between Giorgio by Moroder and Within. Within begins with my piano solo, and it's kind of an important moment in the album, I think, where it's really the first ballad. They needed something to kind of calm everyone down and get them ready for what's a real emotional, I think, moment on the album. I was really impressed at the time because I think it was a solid maybe 2 or 3 years before the album even came out, my session, but they already had the track order. So for me, it was almost a Stanley Kubrick level of planning that was going into this project. At the same time, of course, once you start recording, you're waiting for that nice spontaneous moment. The great thing about music is that when something hits you, it tends to hit you in a direct way, and the effect is simple. And then when you actually go and dissect it, you might realize there's all these sophisticated details in it. Working with your heroes can so often turn out to be disappointing once it actually happens. But with Daft Punk, it far surpassed even my greatest expectations. On Random Access Memories especially, when they themselves willfully removed some of those sonic elements that had made them so famous, and it was as if they were also saying, now that we have access to all these traditional musicians, let's see if we can still make it sound like Daft Punk without necessarily resorting to those elements that people associated them with. Going through the history of all the music that influenced them and bringing it back into the present in a way that befits Daft Punk. Thank you. Wrapped. That I cannot explain. Many rooms to explore, but the doors look the same.